And I'm live again on, I'll be going back to doing the Grim Dawn. I'm currently halfway through Elite, so that's not too bad. Should probably get through that today, and probably just into Ultimate and just start on that, so, I mean, might as well just make a start on that. Hooray. Yeah. I was in the middle of doing these Pain Baron quests. I was gonna start on them, if I remember rightly. Before I start on really the Homestead stuff. Actually, did I? Yeah, that's right. Actually, no, what I was going to do is I was going to go back to Deadman's Gulch because I need to speak to Ulgrim again. But I was also going to see if I could get the medal from Icarix.
So how good were?
That was one other thing I was going to do, which I'll try and remember. Be nice to us and just spawn it right here. No.
That skill's not ready.
I don't think I'm gonna really like farm for it. I'm just gonna try it at once, and if he doesn't drop it again, I'll just come back later. I sort of want to just get through Elite and get on Ultimate, really. There he is. No, he still didn't drop it. Of course. Oh well. There was something else I was thinking of. Yes, I need that blueprint from this troll boss. I can't remember the name of. Yeah, I need the Mistborn Talisman because I know I'll need it for some of the talismans. Actually, if I remember rightly, I did get the Citadel Relic, which I said I was going to make, but then I'm pretty sure that at least part of building that, it's going to need the Mistborn Talisman or some of the relics that will be needed. Honestly, building the relics is sometimes a bit of a task. I bet you're anything, you just dropped another blueprint, but not the one I want. Never mind, he didn't even drop blueprint. Right. Well, I'll just continue on. Like I said, I'll make more of an How much do I want? No, I'm not having any luck. Like, nothing I'm wanting's dropping at the minute. I'm hoping that, like, it's basically saving all my luck for later on when I actually want to set later on, which is also going to be an absolute nightmare to farm, because it's not like you can target farm it or anything. It's just going to be from random things. It'll be fine though. It's not like it's gonna be like a massive upgrade to the gear, yeah, the builds to actually have that set, but it's also I can still make something of it without it. It's obviously just not gonna be quite as effective until I get that. I'm thinking now. I think the sort of the manticore I need is up here. Yeah, it is. There's a specific named one up here I need for the quest. Turret's the audio okay? It looks like the game's running a bit louder than it was. Does it sound okay? It's fine. Okay, that's good. I'm just looking at my meters and I was a bit worried. Basically, it's just so long as you can hear me over all the combat, it's fine. Yeah, you can hear it's just fine. That's good. I haven't changed anything, so I'd hope it was right. Yeah, I'm always looking for this cave entrance that kind of be in a random place. It wasn't so bad this time around. The other place here, it was like hidden away proper. Well, actually, I say it was hidden away. I remember looking back on it later and I'd actually ran straight past it.
Skills not ready.
I did actually level. Had I finished? Right, I've got one more point for here, but I should also be putting more into Storm Touch now that I am going to be doing more Lightning Retaliation. Yeah. Why I really want the Icarix skill medal, because it adds a lot of Lightning Retaliation damage to Overguard. I really need this thing to hit us more. Well, it hurt itself. Oh, Bloodbriar. Easy. Now, I wonder if this needs an advanced component. No, it doesn't. That's good. I think for the devotion point, so I think I might have been at the point where, yes, I was done with Via the Stone Matron. So I was going to start looking at how to get to the Obelisk of Mania, but I'd need two more yellow affinity. And how many points do I need? So I was gonna go for the lion just for the 3 points there, and then it'll be 44, 45, 46, then here 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 50, 53. Might have been something else. It's a bit annoying because I did actually work something out before that essentially had us using the exact number of points, and And it left us with this, where I had this one point out here and I was in here, but I can't remember what I did. So it's something with 5 points. Unless it was actually the Dryad. I think I was going with that idea. This has got a lot of, some resistances, but it's the Dryad's Blessing for the heal that would just go off every now and again. And that's what makes sense to me. Another thing is the minus 10% spirit requirement for Jury. That's just going to really help for some of the end game gear. It means I'll have to put less into spirit. So yeah, Dryad. I know I always usually travel back for this one, yeah. Need enchanted flint. Let's go make one of them. No, actually look through the gear I've already got. Might as well.
I'll give you a good price on what I've got left.
How do they respawn if you don't get what you want? What the for enemies, every time you quit to menu or just exit the game, whenever you reload into it, everything respawns. Like everything that can respawn does, because there are certain things that won't. But as long as you stay in the game, nothing actually respawns. So if you clear out an area, it'll stay cleared until you exit the menu and go back in, or exit the game entirely and go back in. Oh yeah, enchanted flint. I nearly just ran straight back, as I sometimes do. Yes, I was going to look at Citadel. Yeah, so you can see here it needs like 3 other relics and then 2 advanced components. So what I'd have to do is I'd have to go through and create these other relics to create this relic. So for Ancestor, and some of these are like advanced relics or transcendent relics, which also then need other relics. And they right there is the Mistborn Talisman, which is one of the ones I said I'd need. So already I've hit a wall on what I can make there. Relic Forest. Oh, that's another. Sort of defendery retaliation one. I think that's. Yeah, that's a lower level one as well. It's Transcendent one, so. I might be able to. Actually, was that needed? It might have been needed even. To grind, yeah, it's, well, it is like any game like this is just a very grindy game. It's, so it just depends on if you like the grind or not. I happen to like the grind, so. You're a fan of mostly grindy games. Well, you said you play X, you play X4, so, you know. I mean, right now you're playing Monster Train, which seems, I mean, I suppose it's not really like grindy, but it's, you're certainly doing a lot of the same thing. It's a grind with the way you play it. I do keep falling into the trap of like trying to kill a lot of things that I really don't need to. I should only really be stopping for bosses and star enemies. It does just reach a point where it's not really worth killing like every single enemy you see. There's healers. It's like, so in a lot of dungeons and like other areas in Grim Dawn, you'll get different buffs and debuffs, but mostly debuffs really apply to you, or buffs to the enemies or debuffs to yourself. I think Shattered tends to be the worst one. Oh no, it's not, unless they changed it. It's that reduced damage when charge effects but armor is increased. Oh. Unless that's just higher on ultimate, but I'm sure it used to be so much higher than that. Total retaliation damage modified by -4, total damage by -8. I'm sure the values must be used to be way higher than that. Perhaps they changed it, and I just didn't notice. Nerfed. Well, technically buffed, really, because it's an improvement to myself.
skill's not ready. That skill's not ready.
That was everything I needed to do in there. Well, back to here, handing all of these. I might try once more getting that Ikaric scale and the blueprint, because I just kind of want to. Cool. Level 60. Go on. I'm gonna try once more. I mean, saying that for the Citadel Relic as well, I'm not sure if I'd be able to make it, because I might not have actually enough material to make it, because it's going to take quite a bit of resource. Oh, I'm an idiot. I've left me buff bar on. Why have I hang on. Rebuff myself. There we go. Oh, he is here. He's at the first area. Go on. That's a sign that he's going to drop it. Oh, fellow Fuffy. I thought you might end up raiding us. Hello, everyone. How's it going? Did you get the bishop? I was just checking here. He didn't drop it, I don't think. No. Oh, you did. Oh, good. Now you have to go back and do, what's it, the other area that you skipped? I believed in you, Fluffy. Yeah, I can deep wrestle on. Well, right now I'm just having like horrendous luck with drops. But I'm at a point where I don't really want to like try and farm for some gear, but it's like at the same time I kind of do. But it's just not working out. I meant sending all of the possible emotes. I love them, they're great. It is always good to see Fluffy, and yeah, it's always nice to see. I'm loving this spam, it's great. I do like the carrot emote. You could make it a really long carrot. Oh, make it a really long carrot. That's not a long carrot. There's Taro with the old school crab mode. The old ASCII code mode. It's a bobbit carrot. Oh my god, it's getting longer. I knew you'd react to that, Fluffy. Oh, why won't you drop this goddamn thing? Why won't... Nothing's dropping anything I want. It's so annoying. Right, I'm gonna try once more. I really want at least one of these. I always love like random Popcat emotes. I don't know why. I always think they're really funny. Yeah, the ASCII sheep. I shouldn't have asked for the longer carrot now, should I? You kind of want a pop guy. You should totally get one. A fluffy ram pop cat emote. You're looking it up online right now. What, you're gonna try and find someone to make one? Or just a way to do it. If you can commission someone, yeah. Well, obviously there's people that do them because you see them all over the place. Before long, this carrot's gonna go over two messages. Oh, there he is. Come on, please just drop your skill this time. Oh, here we go. No! Come on! Right, I'm not going to try that again. I am going to kill the troll, but I'm not going to sit here and farm them right now. I'd rather just get on to ultimate difficulty, really. Because annoyingly, I'll have to reform all of this at the higher level gear. Alright, Fluffy. See you in a bit. It's nice that it does actually show you who did join from the raid. Long enough care, what? Oh, long enough carrot. I think so. No, these are just absolutely refusing to drop anything that I want, so I'm just going to move on for now. You can make it longer. Just span it over several messages.
I wasn't sure.
I'll skip the play. The Legion is split on...
See what's left. Right. Have I actually got anything that's decent out of all of that? The answer's probably no. I'm gonna keep one Bone Crusher because I know the Bone Crusher is used for the Mistborn Talisman when I actually get one. Oh no, I'm just seeing like this carrot continuing out the corner of my eyes all the time. Wait, what was that? That's a lot of carrot more than you could have. Terry, you broke the carrot. It's too much you see in the dark, my ears. Oh, is this? Oh, that's got no convert lightning, physical lightning. Ah. There's a amulet here, that's no good. Okay. Nope, and there's a medal there as well. Oh, actually, that might be a bit of an improvement. Plus 27 all damage, plus 55% lightning damage. I mean, that's even more all damage than the physical damage on the one I've currently got. That's just a straight upgrade, except I'd lose pierce resistance, which doesn't matter because I'm 126% over cap on pierce. And a bit of chaos, which I'm exactly at cap. I could stand with losing 10% chaos damage. Oh, but that's level 65. I'll keep that in this stash. There we go, we've got the free message carrot. Oh, and Bone Crusher for later.
I'll hold on to that for you.
Right. I suspected for some reason that I did have a devotion point that I didn't spend because I keep doing this. Right, I always go into Dryad. I have no idea how I constantly forget about these devotion points. Is four but one send cause exactly identical to the others. What, a four message carrot? I think I might have enough carrot for a lifetime. Yes, you've solved world hunger. Now, the problem with world hunger is it's not a food problem, it's a logistical problem. What's logistics? What, like, moving items from one area to another? Cargo? Maybe stop to the sword? I'm not sure I follow. Can't Gil. Oh, Guile, even. Can't read, apparently. I don't want that. I don't want a chance to avoid melee attacks. Oh, this is actually, I think, the sword I wanted. Yes! This is the one I was looking for. Empowered lightning rod. Or specifically just lightning rod. It's got lightning retaliation, physical to lightning. It just does lightning itself. Oh no, it does physical itself, but... yeah. Sword plus logistics, no more will. No logistics and no more hunger. I mean, if there was no logistics, there would be no nothing, honestly. Hello, Fluffy. I'm back. Anything can be stopped if you stabbed at it long enough. I mean, some things might take a lot of stabbing. No, I didn't want to go here. I wanted to go Devil's Crossing. I'm going to equip that. Give me this back, please. Are you stabbing people with your carrot? Oh god, if you were trying to do it with stab something death with a carrot, then oh my god. I mean, if it was, I guess if it was frozen. And a bread sword. I can't imagine a bread sword would be that effective? Perhaps I'm wrong. I suppose that depends on how old the bread is. At one point it's just actually going to become a club. But if you have a gluten intolerance, it's deadly. Only if you eat it. Bread swords are what the French Civil War was fought with. It was a true tragedy. Yes, there was certainly a lot of pain on the fields. That'll make more sense if you know the wet French word for bread. Red sword can do anything if you hit it hard enough. I can shove it down someone's throat. Oh my god. Isn't it just like a vicious creature? I'm an as a being of chaos, I can't tell. I thought it was, I mean, I saw some of it on your stream with the Cult of the Lamb, but I thought it was just being in character. Wait for what? In game, my character asked me to sacrifice themselves. Oh, I've been brought back though. Okay, fair enough. Oops. Sorry about that, just knocked me mic. Seen the other side. I mean, if he was brought back, then it means, some random person from one of your Discords, you're an added you. Is that a good or a bad thing? Got removed from the server, no mute servers anymore. Yeah, it's probably just like this spam bot or something. He dropped his ring again. Where is it? I really like that ring. That's actually good. Oh, I might actually use that. Oh, the spirit requirement, but I should get a reducement when I get the next couple of pints with the dryad. I might be able to just equip that as is, perhaps. Otherwise I am gonna have to stop it. Oh no, I've already done that, so I haven't actually spent the point. I haven't spent 2 points. Where am I not spending these? I mean, it's good that there's 2 points because I actually got the spirit requirement on. I can't believe I keep doing this though. I'm just gonna keep that aside. Limb Fluffy with all this chaos. He did not sacrifice enough people. Fluffy just doesn't on Cult of the Lamb. He's such a happy cult leader. I mean, I play completely opposite to how he does on it. So funny. You're a sweet cult leader. It's like that comic of Cult of the Lamb where it's like it's the Crown and it's saying like you're a cult leader, not a, you don't run a nursery or something. Or not, yeah, you're a cult leader. This is a cult, not a daycare. Can't find the other mini boss here. I mean, you don't just sacrifice everyone willy-nilly. You get them to do all of your work for you, then you sacrifice them. I mean, that's sacrificing and bringing them back to life and then trying to kill them if they don't work. I mean, that's only like half as efficient as it could be, because you could have them slave driven, then sacrifice them, then bring back to life and then slave drive them again. You know, might as well make use of all of it. Too scared to disrespect you. I think my followers are just scared all of the time. Like in real life. Oh, that's cruel. Oh, I've been saying... oh, sorry, Elmitten. I've been calling you Eye Mitten, but I realised that's actually a lowercase L. Sorry, thanks for the follow, though. I only noticed because it came up in all caps for me, for the follow thing. You guys played the cult leader a bit long. I mean, it is, it's literally called Cult of the Lamb. And it is like... Oh, yes, of course. The happy face. Don't forget the happy face of the map. Too bad you don't have a PC. You can't make the stuff for yourself. Is a Cult of the Lamb not on consoles? I can't remember. No, you're on mobile. Oh, do you not have any? It's definitely not on mobile. Well, perhaps you'll be able to get it later. On stream, you are nice. Off stream, you are also nice, to be honest. Yeah, I actually did say that as well. But being chaotic is more fun than being the most something, I guess. The nicest thing. I think so. That's sometimes like if any, like, for games that let you be, like, nice or evil, half the time being evil's way more funny. You end up marrying everyone. That's got some sort of chaotic energy to it, though, as well. Because if you're just, like, going around marrying literally everyone. They did not want to be evil. The wonderful option. I get the feeling though that Elminton's like the exact opposite of you, Fluffy, where they would only actually make evil characters and nothing else for any game that they play. I do a mix. I like doing kind of both. Like sometimes I'll make a nice character, sometimes I'll make an evil character. Just depends on how I feel. Find it really hard to make an evil character. I mean, to be fair, I think most of the time when I do play a game where you've got the option, I tend to make a good character first. The only one that I haven't really done that on was actually Cult of the Lamb, where it's like, well, kind of... it's kind of inherent in the actual game itself. Just kind of drives you towards it. I need to be very careful here. I don't have much air to resist. Not that hard to make a bad character. It depends on the game, because some games, like, you can only be a good character, so it's a bit difficult there. Not to say it's not worth trying. You found a way in every single game to be evil. what about something like Nintendogs? I suppose you could still be evil in that, but you'd have to be evil to puppies. Now, could you do that? Yes! Oh my god, what is wrong with you? Oh my god. You truly are evil. I wonder if any of these are an upgrade. That's probably an upgrade because I lose some pierce, which I'm fine with, and gain a bit more chaos. That does have 57 offensive ability on, though. No, I don't think that's worth it. Many things. Just evil in many ways. Dubious little creature. And you won't stop until the whole world is evil. I mean, the whole world is already evil, though, so I mean, you're already ahead of that.
There was much. I see my scouts have.
Or control everyone. I think that's more of a reasonable evil goal. Are you. Oh no, are you Amazon Prime? Where's your Google? Oh no.
There are two others.
Oh, do you know what? When I made the choice of these two before, I thought it wouldn't really matter, but I think actually I do want to join the Kaiman's Chosen because I think they've got an enchantment that adds Apple is so much worse than everything else. Yeah, probably. I'd probably agree with that. Yeah, Kaiman's Chosen had an enchantment that had lightning retaliation on, so I don't think it's gonna be that worth it, but I just don't need Death Vigil, definitely not. I mean, I know I've lost some rep to, like, it's essentially reset the rep on that, but I think in the long run it's gonna be better for us. By the time you're done, everyone will be a furry. I think it's already everyone here, to be honest, so. Right, I was going to use this ring. No. Where am I going to use that? It's that, like... It's a shame that's given us a bunch more pierce resist that I just really don't need. Both of these rings are giving us vitality resist that I am under cap on. And element resist, which I'm barely over cap on. But this gives element resist as well. So I'd be losing vitality. I'm just going to keep a hold of that and then kind of decide on it. I think I've got another ring in here, actually, that was level 65. Oh, no, it was a medal. But everything in the world would be so much better. All except the little woman, aka... Yeah. Oh, the Karens. Oh, the Karens or iPod kids will be sacrificed. I don't know, the Karens will all want to see your manager. Off people on Reddit? What's wrong with Reddit? Is that making me a target? I don't really use Reddit. I use Reddit to look at things, but I'm not really active on it. But enough to make me a target. Target of your evil plans. Reddit has a... Everywhere's got a bunch of furry haters, so, I mean... It's not just there. It's almost... Kill them all! Oh, what? I mean, Valiant is certainly answering this game, but I don't think that really applies to actual life. I think the far better answer is generally righteous indignation. Just take offense with everything. If you're crazy enough, violence is always the best answer.
May the light of
No, I didn't want to take that quest. It doesn't matter. I'm actually going to hide it, though, because I didn't want that quest. Am I winning? Honestly, I don't even know anymore. When you remind me of Max from... Yes, it is it. It's Max. You are Max. You're running on all sugar and blueberries. Maybe that's why you're going so crazy. You're both creatures of chaos. Who? Who else? Me? I don't think I'm that chaotic. Thought that quest had killed Belovia. I don't even know what it said. And you just see how much attention I've hit to the quest. Your sister thinks you were just talking to yourself. I mean, that's all what I'm doing right now. It's like... Anyone that's listening to us, that's exactly what it sounds like I'm doing. Johnny, this is all part of your imagination. No! Oh shit, there is actually an arcane enemy in here. I need to watch out for that one. Wake up. But I like the sleep. And just 5 more minutes. You're gonna be living school.
No.
That would actually like be a true nightmare, just to wake up and be a kid again. You'd be like, shit, I've got to go through all of that again. Oh god, yeah. World's longest stream. A world's longest nightmare. You have 3 seconds. Should we get 1-0? Oh, you're counting up. Oh, right, okay. 2. 3. Nothing happened. Ground your room north. Technology. Get out, but who cancel? I'm clearly lost on that. I'm clearly being a dum dum. Can someone explain, please? Oh. Yes, absolutely. An angry parent would totally start 3. Grounded in no electronics for a week. If you did something about this, say your whole name. Oh yes, I've definitely had my whole name from my parents. That would be brutal. He says, yes it would, wouldn't it? Oh my god. I mean, it wouldn't have mattered so much when I was a kid. I'd be like, oh no. No, not me Mega Drive. Back then it was no going out. Yeah, it probably was, but I never went out anyway. Oh, your mum would say I'm getting your dad. No, my mum was way more threatening than my dad. My dad would say he's getting me mum. second that everything goes silent. Oh yeah, yeah, absolutely. You're scared of me more than me die. Oh god, you really don't want to get on the bad side of me, Mom. Oh my god. She's savage. Oh, I actually do want to kill pretty much everything in here because I do want these Chthonic seals. There's never such a thing as two chill parents or two mean parents. It's just one nice and one mean. It's like good cop and bad cop. Well, that, I guess that really depends. I mean, if I'm honest, a lot of parents don't really stay together. So you can't really have that, but I think any that stay together, yes, you always have good cop and bad cop. For you, it's parents and step-parents. Yeah, that's what I mean. It's amazing because I think like when I was a kid, I was like one of the very few kids whose parents were still together. But you said you had the opposite thing happen to you, Fluffy, which is so weird to me. Like you said that your parents had split, but like all of your friends' parents were still together. Yeah, that's so strange to me. Like it's so alien. You're also the only one who doesn't have siblings. That's a good thing. I don't know. I think it's quite nice to have a brother or sister, I think. I mean, I say that because I've got a brother, so that's probably why. Ooh. Don't kill me. It's crazy weird. I think maybe it's a regional thing as well, actually. You don't know how many siblings you have. I don't really know how to respond to that. Not to die.
That skill's not ready. That skill's not ready.
Oh, yeah, I remember now. These Chaos Crystals just do so much damage. So I don't want to be there. Oh, they're everywhere, though. I'm stuck. Oh, they do despawn. Thank God. Everyone finds that weird. I mean, I guess in some ways it kind of is, but I guess at the same time it's not necessarily that you're always going to know who your siblings are. Depends on family situation, I guess. I've had three step parents in your life. Being all horrid, overcompensation for being your actual parent type. Oh god, I don't know if that. Well, I guess, is that worse than being ignored? I don't know. Because that is the other thing that can happen.
Can't do that yet.
Both are bad. Well, yeah, of course. But then it's just like, what's the lesser of two evils? I mean, I suppose the best outcome you could possibly have with any of that is if they're just trying being a normal parent. I mean, not that I've really got much to say in any of it, though, because like I've had like possibly like the perfect upbringing, so it's like. And I'd struggle to contribute anything to the conversation on that. Agreed. You could say a few things with your family is super broken. For as long as you live, you've never seen someone having perfect upbringing. I'm saying like perfect as in like me parents were like fine. Like I don't know any of my extended family really, so there's that. But that's it. Compared to a lot of people, I seem to have had a good upbringing. So I always find it a bit weird when talking about it because I've always like I'm like, well, yeah, I can't really relate because it's like it's been good for me. So I always feel a bit bad. Don't feel bad. I feel bad because I had a nice upbringing. Unless I want to adopt all of us. No, no, I don't. This is so privileged. Yeah, I can't believe you had a normal childhood. So bad. How dare I? Very dare I. It's one of those once in a million things. It maybe is. I don't know. Is it? I mean, maybe it is because it is. It does certainly seem rare. 1%, probably. Just bullying me for having a good upbringing. I already got that in school, to be fair. There's so many effects going on right now that I can't actually see myself standing in the chaos fields under us.
No.
Your parents are still together. What kind of weird kid has two parents? You're so weird. Two parents, two parents. Oh no. I wonder if that is actually an insult. Probably is, knowing kids. Way too much damage there.
I can't do that yet.
It's how it's delivered. What kind of good kid was low? Don't know, to be honest, can't relate, and Johnny should feel bad. Right, that's Act 3 done with. So, oh wow, I've not hoarded in so much.
I don't know what you did.
So many quests. You know, thoroughly confused on what's happening. Don't worry, I've been confused from the start. I'm just rolling with it all.
Perfectly simple entrance.
Come see what's left of my wares.
You're watching a Johnny stream. Johnny Cougar stream. Oh, you're planning world domination. Whoa, we're pinky in the brain. You forgot about that, but world domination. It's just world domination, just all that's on your mind. They're actually good in some ways. Less damage, but some resistances on them. I might keep them just as something that I might need for different gear. Element invite, you have to go. Okay, well, thanks for joining along anyway, Element. It's been different. I'm sure you'll take over the world soon enough, so. all hail Mitten. You know, so I might as well get that in there before it happens. Not immune to Mitten propaganda. They're quite good as well. Legs. That's a decent ring. It's a shame I'm not really getting any retaliation rings, though. That might just be another one I keep a hold of and think about. I'm certainly getting a lot of gear where I'm just like, oh, I'm going to put this away and think about it. It's just going to stick in me stash, and it's going to stay there until I sell it. That medal could be something I actually use, although I did have a medal that was 65 in the stash. I don't need that. Oh, I forgot to sell that. These are things I'm just thinking about. What's this ring? Oh, it was vitality resistance I was having the problem with. Yeah. That doesn't have any, does this? No. So yeah, I'm just having a bit of a problem. It's a bit difficult sometimes to replace gear when you're just losing a bunch of stuff that you need. I mean, that's almost 20% resistance just gone because it changed the ring. This is worth just keeping them around, just in case I find something that adds a bunch of vitality resist, and then I can just change things around. Where was I at? I need to hand in some quests, especially in Homestead. There's a bunch of quests hand in there.
I am told I could not when the Legion was forced to... I've already informed...
was that?
See anything you like?
Oh yeah, I'm actually honored with the Black Legion as well. I forgot about this. I don't think I've bought any of these either. Yeah. More components that are missing. And a relic.
Put it to good use. I'll give you a good price on what I've got left.
Oh. Oh, that's interesting. Oh, and there's vitality resistance on this as well. Okay. I might have found a replacement ring for that creating ring. Because at least when that's got physical retaliation on it, that'll partially get turned into lightning retaliation. So the acid retaliation is doing nothing. So yeah, actually, I'm going to buy one of these rings and use it. So that's going to be worth it.
Come see what's left of my wares.
I will need to look through these augments as well at some point.
Got something you need, Stash?
I'm not going to do that right now, but I will do that soon. Okay. Well, that's good. Okay, so now I'll just be moving on to Fort Icon, and then it's just the rest of this. This last act, Act 4, doesn't really take that long, so I'll probably get this done in not long. But what I am going to do, though, I'm going to have a little break, because I think I need just a little break. So I will be back shortly. Thank you. And hello, I'm back from a little break. So, I was... Yeah, I'm just moving on to our fort icon now. Oh, wait, I just leveled as well. I think I've only... Yeah, only 1 point left to put there. Now it's a case of... Oh, something I'll want to start getting up as well as my armor absorption. It'll be worth putting at least 1 point in here because it'll immediately be 2 points because of the belt. I'm just adding extra armor absorption, so it just means that the armor's more effective that I'm wearing. Ideally, I want the armor absorption to be 100%, but I need to have components for that, really. Or just put a bunch of points in there, but I'm not going to have the points to do that. So... Yeah, that's something to think about a bit later on. Things aren't really hitting us that hard with it. Armor's only really for physical damage, so it only really becomes an issue later. For now, I'm having more problems with things that can be dealt with resistance wise. Because I mean, it was it's still aether. It's always aether for us. I don't know why I'm having so much trouble with it.
Can't do that yet.
I really have to watch out for the aether ground effect. I mean, avoiding any ground effects is ideal anyway. Like, don't stand in the fire. Fire is bad. I actually don't think there is... good is what I've got. I mean, they've got a whole bunch more armor. They've got aether resist. I mean, it's level 65 anyway, but... I'll think about that. It's another for the maybe pile. Which one heal? Do you heal? I think you heal. Do they both heal each other? This is going to be so annoying if they do. Problem is, I just don't do enough damage against casters. Especially these ones that like resist a lot of damage while they've got the bubble up. Right, you must have been the healer. Still like to be a charge then from up here. It feels like sometimes it lets you do silly charges that have you go over all over the place, and sometimes it just doesn't. Probably just depends on the terrain, but. I'm sure this one needs a rare component, and I'm convinced it's Amber. I know at least one of them does. I've said one of them before, but I think it's this one. Yes. I was actually right. No, I've just gone. I clicked on the big portal. I want to go to me little portal. Now the question is, did I remember to spend my last devotion point? I've got 3! What? I have no idea. I have no words, honestly. 0. I don't know why I keep doing this. You'd think I'd actually, for once, remember. I always manage to get get a point and then immediately get distracted by something. I don't even know what. Like, anytime, it's like... I swear these devotion points just appear out of nowhere. Stuff to pick up all the time now. I mean, I could if I wanted to be a lot more selective with the loot I'm picking up, but I want to say it gives you enough space so that you can just pick up more stuff and then sort it out later.
Good. It's precise.
I'll give you a good price on what I've got left.
Quickly go through the stuff I've got here. I did get another couple of these flesh warp plate mails. I don't know if any of them are going to be any good, but... I mean, in some way that's rolled slightly better, but then the lower offensive ability, it depends on how much offensive ability I get from 5% cunning. I might just equip that. Yeah, only goes down like 21 points. But overall it gives us sort of better things and slightly higher resistances and more retaliation damage, so I think I will use that. Also, I don't actually think I need to use the Silk Swatch because that's just for pierce and bleeding, which I'm overcapped. So I could put something else in the chest. Maybe it's a chain for the extra offensive ability again. Yeah, I think I will keep them to use. This is one of Thorns, and it's got 4% offensive ability on. That actually puts it up, but what am I losing? Poison, acid resist. Pierce and... No, this does have pierce on and element resist on. Does that go under? No. I might use that one as well. Okay, so at least like a couple of things. I'll go in the stash.
See you around.
Got something you need stashed.
I do want the leathery hide out of that, so I think I'll just go back and get that, but don't want the chains of Valoran in. Just entrapment duration as well. Can be good. What else can go in this? There is also the idea of having some of the ones that increase armor absorption. I can't remember what they're called. Skilled hides. They do go in chest as well. I'm not having so much issues with damage, although it is starting to become more of a thing now. I am taking a bit more damage as time goes on. I tell you what, I'll go with this for now and I'll just see how I feel with that. Because that'll bring us up to, what, 92% armor absorption, so... Not devotion. I'm going to go back to Devil's Crossing to grab the components out, get that leathery hide in the head, and then move on. I've kept all these materials on them, but I'm just going to leave them. They don't take up that much space. Oh, and I have the boots as well. Meh. I mean, they're legendary, so they're fairly obvious. Just thought as well, I'm pretty sure I'd be able to get me Aether Resist actually up to cap, because I'm convinced at least one of the factions gives an augment that would increase me Aether Resist on rings.
Come see what's left of my wares.
Aether Resist right there, rings and amulet, yeah. 78%. There we go. That's just going to make this bit less painful. Honestly, the time I actually wanted the flesh orb plate mail when I was just trying to grab it, it was never dropping, and now it's dropping all the time. It really is a desire sensor. Yeah, it's a bit. It is frustrating. Do you know what would happen, right? If it could drop blueprints, I could guarantee you that troll boss, after it dropped it would drop it every single time. And the only reason that I can remember so well that troll boss drops that blueprint is because I've done this before, where I've reset all my progress and had to form up a thing, and then I didn't realize where you'd need to get the Mistborn talisman. It was from that troll boss, and I remember farming it forever and ever and ever, and it just wasn't dropping. So I dearly hope that doesn't happen again, but it might. Another fleshwalk bulwark? Oh wait, no, the bulwark's the shield. No, never mind. Oh, I thought it was just I thought it was just constantly dropping him, but no. I mean, the problem is I'll need one in the next level range of it, which I think is 72. Actually, it might be sooner than that. I'd have to look that up. Because, like, all of the monster infrequents normally have, like, level ranges of where the next sort of tier of it drops. But I can't remember what them tiers are. I know essentially the top level monster infrequents are, I think, 92? Level 92 or something? Oh! That's pretty good. One high leggings. They're actually really good. Nice. Something actually nice. They look epic. But Terra, these aren't epic. They're legendary. What's hilarious though is that actually is like the sort of standard epic colour for most games is purple, so I think that's quite funny that they've actually used I think as much before when I ran through here on last difficulty, I don't need anything here. I don't need to stop for anything. I'll just keep running. Try not run over every single mine though. I mean, it already feels like I'm taking a lot less damage from all the earth enemies since I got the ether resist up. It's been trailing low throughout the whole thing until now, so nice to finally have. Still a bit spicy though. Avatar of Chaos has Mitten returned.
Thank you.
Right, devotion point. I should only have one devotion point, right? Right. Right, good. I'm not going that mental. How many points do I need? Is this giving two for pillar 11? No, it's giving three. One more point, and that'll be 100% of armor absorption.
Worked out. We can't quick thinking. I will.
Got something you need stashed?
I'll give you a good price on what I've got left.
Oh, yeah. I didn't actually look at that properly. No, it's. Oh. Oh, they dropped a colossal fortress. I mean, it's higher level and got more block chance and... But it's got far worse physical resist and... Less retaliation. I don't really think that one's as good. Even though it's a high level one. Flesh or Plymail, which is of thorns, so it's actually got some actual retaliation damage on it rather than just increasing it, but I mean, if anything, that would just be a side grade. I don't think it's worth messing over. Yeah, well, I'm not going to be able to use these legendaries till 65, but then I've also got this for 65. Doesn't mean that I'm not going to use them, because that's just going to be way better.
Took you long. The Cult of Gathon, it appears that...
Well, not much more to go. Just need to do the blood wagons and then just through the area to the last boss. So, Nelly unlocked ultimate difficulty. I can't remember all the locations these blood wagons can spawn. Well, there's one. Which one's that one? It's a northern one, so it's just gonna be somewhere. Somewhere over this side. Oh, it's right there. Oh, perfect. I don't need to kill any of these. Just thought I completely forgot to get a devotion shrine. I even opened up a portal for it and everything, and I just left it there and I forgot about it. I'm gonna go back for it. Yeah, leaving a portal open to save time to go back to doesn't help if you forget to go back to it. Yeah, memory error. I get a lot of those. That's why I end up with loads of devotion points that I keep forgetting to spend.
I mean, thankfully, I'm nearly at the maximum. Have I checked recently? I haven't, but I have just done a shrine. There is no way I got one. Like, I haven't done one. I'm going to check anyway, because now you've said it, I'm going to... But I know I don't. And if I do have them, then I know something's going very wrong. No, none, see. But then I'm very nearly at the cap, so I'm nearly got 55 out of 55. And then I don't need to worry about them again. Well, until I make another character. Thankfully, I haven't had, like, the urge to try a different build just yet, which sometimes I do get while I'm, like, mid-level. So far, I've been quite enjoying this one, so... You were about to ask how I felt about this one. Yeah, no, so far, So it seems, I mean, it's hard to say because it's, at the minute it just feels like any other retaliation build that you'd have. Like, I've leveled up a few retaliation builds, and to be honest, it's something I always like. I don't know why, specifically, because I guess it's nice to, with the idea of building something that will be at the point where it can just face tank almost everything. Like, you can't just stand there and take all her hits. But I don't know, I've got a good feeling about this. Need advanced material. Right. Blood Fang. Spend it. Oh, plus 3 maximum pierce resist. Nice. And then the other side, I'll just get a bunch more defensive ability, and that'll finish out the devotion points. Right, so now it's just on to the last boss. Though, if I remember rightly, there is also possibly another devotion shrine that appears in this last dungeon-y area. But I'm not sure if that only appears on ultimate or not. It doesn't, like, it'll look at the minute that there's so many more shrines than you need, and there definitely is. But it's built with the idea that you can get these merits that just let you bypass difficulties. It's to the point that if you really wanted to, you could actually play a character entirely in Ultimate only. It's be really hard, but you could do it if you wanted to. But with the idea of that, there is enough devotion shrines in Ultimate alone to, like, more than enough in Ultimate alone to get the full 55 points. Yeah, there is one. So it must appear here on Elite and Ultimate. Because this one's not there on normal. I'm sort of glad about that as well, because I am in using all of my constant use abilities. Might as well sort of put it on that because it's a chance on block. But it's nice to get that now because all of these abilities, so any of the abilities that add skills level up as well and need experience. So getting that bit earlier on is actually nice. It means all of these quests I'm doing will contribute to the experience of that devotion skill. So I only need one. Oh! Does savagery add armor absorption? Where did I get that from? Did I spend the pint I needed? Hang on. I take this off, does that go down to 20? What? Oh! It was on here, wasn't it? 18% on just here, right. Okay. I mean, I guess that means I either don't need the component or I don't need the skill. Right. Okay. That's interesting. I'll have a think about that. I didn't even think about that. Also, I wonder if I'm overdoing Counter-Strike now, because you can only level a skill, so it'll go up to whatever the level is, and then you can get more on your armor. But that can only go up to 10 past the level, so this is on 26 of 16. I'm not sure if I'm overdoing that, and if I am, it means it's wasted points. I could take them out and put them elsewhere. The only way really to tell that would be if I try to unspend some. now we're trying to think of where best to spend the points, really. I could also, just for extra attacks that happen, I could just put a point in Zohan's technique and Marconian's advantage just to give, because these are all chance on hit. So these always just have a chance to go off whenever. So yeah, I'm going to do that. Just some extra damage that happens on me attacks. Oops. Let's just travel back and forth and back and forth. I'm wondering if I'll just be able to sit here the whole fight, not move. Thank you. I mean, so far I haven't needed to move. I don't know if I will in phase three, but yeah. This is what these sort of builds will be, let you do. They'll just let you sit there and not have to worry about any attacks. Nah. Better sit there and face tank the whole fight. Not really been much to consider. Yeah, I was sort of considering the middle, but honestly, I'll be trying to farm that Ikaric skill. I might try and do that a bit before moving on to ultimate. So I wouldn't mind one. Probably be worth as well going back to normal difficulty to go to the vendor and see if I can pick up a better Colossal Fortress shield. And I've just remembered, because I can see it here, when you get up to Honored, you can get writs to increase the reputation gains. I should have been getting them earlier. I need to get them from all of the faction I'm honored with.
You've returned. So our great moment of triumph is...
I'll do this quest. I'll pick up the writs. Now that I remembered that. I'll probably do Icrix and try and get that medal. No, I know I can't just do that because he does reduce resistances and I'm not even at Aether Cap, so it's definitely pushing us right down. Nearly killed us right at the end. Ugh. So I'll need one from Homestead. The Rovers and Devil's Crossing. There's, I might even be able to pick one up from, I don't know what is, there it is. Be able to pick one up from the Coven of Ugdenborg. Get there eventually. Devil's Crossing, Homestead. That's pretty much it. But I'll do that when I'll not be able to do it on Elite because I don't even have the area unlocked.
Come see what's left of my wares. See you around.
See anything you like. See you around. See what's left of my wares. I'll give you a good price for what I've got left. I'll give you a good price for what I've got left.
Okay. So we'll try again to get the this medal and probably the blueprint again while I'm at it. So I am gonna need it. I like it when it just puts them here. There it is. Aggressive Icric skill of protection. Aggressive is offensive ability. That's good. Protection is defense. I think that overall that's probably... Oh, player level 70. Oh. Well, I've got one. That's so annoying, though. Okay, so that also means that I know that the next main range of these things will be level 70. Okay. Well, I've got one, so at least I've got it. Like, I don't need to worry about that right now. That'll probably just last us until I get the level 92 one or something. At least I got it. Well, finally, at least it's finally dropped. I mean, I'll have to do it all over again when I actually want a good roll one, because that is actually, I think that is actually going to be part of me end game gear. But unfortunately for something, right? So unfortunately for something like that, when it's the green ones, I'll need to get one good rolls of it. Two, I'll need to get the correct affix and suffix on it. So, it's gonna be a nightmare actually farming that. I mean, at least for most other gear, it's not so bad because, like, all of the gear just drops from whatever. But for Monster Infrequence, it'll only drop from specific monsters, and it's worse when it's specifically just one boss. So you just fight that one boss, then you've got to reset and go back. I mean, what will end up happening is it'll be like sort of a farming cycle where you go through, and that'll be like one thing in a run, essentially. Now, if I'm really lucky, this guy, I'll drop the blueprint. He did not. No, but I did get the scale, so I've got that. So otherwise I'll be going to ultimate, but I did say I wanted to go back to normal so I could try and get a new shield. Just to see if there's anything any better than what I've got. If not, I'll just keep running with it, what I've got. But it also gives it the opportunity to go to the Corbin's Refuge and get a rip from them as well.
Come see what's left of my wares. Iron wealth.
He should be higher level. 55 what level? Yeah, so they are a bit. See if there's anything here that could be better. Wait, hang on. That is a double rare. Keep us colossal of an imposing presence. That's probably why it's 364,000 bits. Like a double rainbow. I mean, that's ridiculous. I don't think it's worth getting that for how ridiculous that is. Because it's just too low level. I mean, if I saw something like that at high level, I'd be like all over it, but... I mean, how much do I have? I've got 1 million bits. I hate how good that is. Oh, no. I wish it was I don't know what else this can roll as. I can afford it, but it just seems like a little bit of a waste of money on a like a level 55 double rare. It's not even like it, the problem is if it was say like Tempest, I think Tempest is for lightning damage. If it was something like that, I probably would go for it. But it's not. So I don't think it's as really worth it. And I don't think any of the others are. Are quite so good. I tell you what, I'm not going to get that one, but what I'll do is I'll just move and then come back, so it'll reset the vendor. Just take a little more. You've got to like leave the area for a few, I think like 10 seconds or something, and then it resets the vendor.
See anything you like?
I definitely don't want to sell that. I'm going to put me stash now. Oh, there's not a stash here. He moved outside.
Save storage. No questions.
Oh, and I got level 65, so I can actually equip these. And I guess this medal until I can use this. I guess I'll sell that one in that case. And these two rings, I'm still... I'll keep these honors to see if I'll actually use them.
I'll keep an eye out. Come see what's left of my wares.
Right, are these any better? Actually, I did want to sort of think about this one again. Oh no, it's because this is always going to be physical damage to aether damage. I was just thinking about the overguard. That reduced cooldown on overguard and total damage to overguard because of Ikric's skill. I think. Yeah. I'll look once more. I'll just probably think about equipping these and what I'm gonna do that way around. Now, a big problem here is my element resists here and bleed. Because these are like under cap here in normal. These go down 50% when I go up to ultimate. So these would be like 13%. Am I getting any with these buffs? I can't remember. No. Do I get any with savagery? No. So they were giving 25 element resist. I mean, also I have lost, was it 18% from here as well? Just from the component. The only one that's looking really healthy is piercing. I don't know, maybe I'll get a really lucky roll on one of these shields.
See anything you like?
No. No, I'm not going to keep looking at these shields, though, because it is just mid-level ones. There's not really much point in constantly looking through them. I'll see if there's anything I can really do about new resistances, though. I'm also... Yeah, I'm putting a point in here, but I do need the Aether Resist up. Because that'll also go down 25% from here. So it would be capped on Ultimate with me current setup, but... Like, I'll just take that out because I'll just reuse that anywhere. Oh, I could take out this lodestone, lose some electric damage, lightning retaliation, but I could then put in another wardstone and get that element resist up. Actually, I'm going to do that. Oops. Do I have a spare? I do have a spare wardstone. Oh, and I could take this out, I think. I think it's 15. I could refund these points. There's a lot of options. And these rings as well. I was thinking about these rings. See, that one's got element resist on. Oh, but... No, because... Depends on me. Poison resist? 21%? No. And that would only gain it a little bit of element resist and more pierce. Actually, frustratingly, that's... Well, probably not frustrating. I think that actually, in this case, would probably be better than using that one. Actually, why was I thinking that one was better? I think it was just because it was higher level and I wasn't really looking at it properly. Never mind. Actually, no, don't keep item. Keep add-on. I was wrong. It was this one I wanted to use. Well, that's worked out. I'll keep them rings. I'm not sure if I'm going to be using them or not, but... Okay. Oh, wait. There was one more thing I need to do in Elite, which actually I'll do now. I still need to do the Forgotten Path questline for an extra ability point and attribute point.
I might as well do that so everything's then done in Elite. Oh, well, everything necessary is done in Elite. And then there's only Ultimate to think about. I was worried for a second I didn't actually pick up the runestone. There. I cannot FaceTime. I nearly, but not quite. It's here, I think. Yeah.
kills me.
Yeah, not bad. nothing's really doing too much damage to us still, which is nice. I mean, this isn't ultimate yet, but these are like harder quests anyway. Yeah, the build seems really good so far in ramming up now. I mean, it's all right. I mean, this, like, you could probably be at a bit better position with some builds, like right now. But I don't know. This is just like nice and easy and a bit casual. Like, I'm not trying to be quick with her or anything, so. If I wanted to be quick with her, I would just leveled up the whole way with Force Wave and kept going that way, but. I mean, a Force Wave build now would still be way more damage than I'm doing right now. Do you think Force Wave is better? Not necessarily. I think it's better for leveling. It needs less gear. The gear requirement's much lower, so it's easier to make work. It's definitely something that's like, it's something I'd probably suggest for just leveling. If any class combination with Soldier, probably just level most of the way with Force Wave. It depends on how much you like that as well. See, the problem I've got is I don't really like using Force Wave. I'll use it to start with because it's just really powerful and it's easy to use. It's the same as like some other things where it depends on the class. Like, sometimes you'll, there's some builds that you cannot do until you've got certain gear. So, it's impossible to level as some classes that you might want to run. At least until you've got, like, max level in the gear you want. In that case, for things like that, you'll have a separate leveling build and end game build. So technically, when I started this off, I had a separate build for leveling, and I could have kept with that the whole way to like level 94, which level 94 is where there's not any gear that would the maximum level of gear in this is 94. So, as soon as you hit level 94, there's nothing that you wouldn't be able to equip. I've got a few levels to go, I do. It all slows down as well. I mean, depending on how it goes as well, I might end up, there's a, for the Malmuth Resistance faction, once you get the full faction with them, they sell an experience potion to double all experience gains, which you can trade between characters as well, but, like, because I haven't used anything like that, or any experience items, because it's been, like, from scratch, I might end up actually using... like gaining faction and then using them XP potions just to get us right up to level cap. Oh, golem bomb greens are good. They're not a retaliation one, but they're definitely a very defensive one. I don't think I'll use them in this case, but mythical ones I might end up using. I'm already at the movement cap. I don't need to worry so much about movement speed. Yeah, this is a good point though. Oh man, what about Fluffy? I think. Unless you've just been lurking this entire time. You've just made the biggest mistake. Oh no, what have you done? No, you've been lurking. Yeah, Fluffy, who have you married? Don't, no, don't start this again, please God no. I will not allow it. I could actually face tank him. No, but for real, I heard a dog barking while I was in the bathroom. Open the window to see what the fuss is. An ambush by 7 moths. Oh, no. Oh, that's, yeah, that's it. That is unpleasant. Not so notoriously annoying to remove. Yeah, I mean, you can sometimes remove them by just turning out lights and then having a light on outside. They'll, half the time they'll just go towards that, but then half the time they'll also just get stuck on an open window, much like flies. you can grab spiders, but moths, you are, you think moths are worse than spiders? I don't know. The harder to catch. Well, they're harder to catch because they can fly. I mean, I'm so glad that spiders can't fly. I'm sure there are spiders that can fly, and I don't even want to think about that, to be honest. But yeah. You really hope there isn't. Oh. Right, I think I'm pretty much finished with everything on Elite. Everything that I need to really do on Elite's done. That's another ring to consider. This goes on the pile of other rings that I'm considering. Safe storage, no question. I'll keep an eye out. There's another ring there as well. That's not good.
Come see what's left of my wares.
I'll keep your source.
Okay, well, I think with that, that's pretty much Elite done. I'll be moving on to Elite, but I think I'm probably not going to start that right now. I think I'll probably end the stream here, so it'll be like just ultimate going forward. And I'll just start on that next stream. What I might do is I might try and make the Citadel route. I'll probably just go and try and do that, because that's just going to be really, like, there's so much to do for that. Like, I'd have to look at the other relics. Like, honestly, making relics, it feels like sometimes you've got to make a spreadsheet just so you can actually keep track of all of the materials and different things you need. So I'm not going to do that on stream. But I'll see if I can make it, or at least get everything that I'd need, so I'd know what I need to make it, so it's not so much of a pain in the ass to do. But otherwise, yeah, I think I'll end the stream there. But thanks for staying around and being there for it, and I'll see you again next time. Been good again. Laughs were hard. Another good stream now. Thank you, Fluffy. Thank you for being here, Tara. Okay. Right. I'll end that now then. I'll see you later.